Have you ever noticed how our world is commanded by the media? Social networks have taken over our lives and more people care about what they post on the internet. Recently, one person approached me in revolt because he was deleted from a text messaging group. In the face of this new idea of relationship, the problem of appearances arises. In social networks, we carefully select what we want to appear, even if it doesn't correspond with who we really are. In reflecting on the world of appearances in which we live, the great thinker Zygmunt Bauman, contextualizing Descartes, affirms that to exist in this dark world, it is necessary, above all, to appear. Propagandize, so to say. I show up, therefore I exist. The problem worsens when the world of appearance reaches religious life, and we no longer care about what we essentially are, but only with what we seem to be. In chapter 29 of the book of Isaiah, we find the terrible lamentation of God over the people who followed him only in appearance. In verse 13, we read, "Therefore the Lord said, this people approach me, and with their mouth and with their lips honor me, but their heart is far from me, and their fear toward me is thought by the commandment of men." Lips talking about God while the heart is distant from him. This is the religion of appearance, which in addition to bringing a great loss to the church, brings terrible evil on who carries it. Such an individual wears a heavy mask, and this cannot be carried for a lifetime. And you, how is the relation between what you say and what you practice? You know, one of the most important qualities in our world is called coherence, which creates a harmonious relation between what we say and what we do. So don't be incoherent. Do not live only on appearances.